bringing philosophy to life. Philosophy thrives in the Agora. In the ivory tower, it wilts and dies. My name is Albert Anderson. This series of podcasts is brought to you by Agora Publications and Saga Talks in an attempt to connect daily human life throughout the globe with universal ideas and principles. Each week, the various media present a confusing set of events and actions that invite deeper reflection. These podcasts attempt to identify and analyze one or more of those events and the fundamental ideas and principles they embody. Bringing Philosophy to Life, episode number 15, AI, Mind the Gap. Artificial intelligence, AI, continues to be a major topic in the current news, especially in the business sections of the various media. As I explained in the previous episode, replacing human beings with digital computers promises immense cost savings for the corporations that play such a strong role in contemporary life throughout the world. The purpose of this series is to bring philosophy to life by identifying and examining philosophical issues and principles connected with current events. The most important philosophical question concerns the meaning of life itself. So, it is important to pause and remember that doing business is not the purpose of life. Business is a means, not an end. Money is a means, not an end. Too often, the media organize the news cycle around economic issues and events rather than the much broader range of activities and topics that make life worth living. The coverage of politics is dominated by economic concerns, so the dominant question in the media is how many jobs will be lost if artificial intelligence continues to replace the human brain. In the previous episode, I pointed out that scientific materialism is the worldview that has eclipsed other ways of thinking since the 17th century, leaving us with what Alfred North Whitehead calls the reason of Ulysses, which is shared with the foxes, and ignoring the reason of Plato, which is shared with the gods. Economic topics dominate the political realm because currently the two major alternatives, capitalism and various forms of Marxism, both embrace forms of materialism. In capitalism, owning the economic means of production is essential, even when those means are so-called intellectual property. Although Marxism, also known as dialectical materialism, is opposed to capitalism, it remains an economic and material model, even when the workers own the means of production. In the United States, especially in recent years, the so-called culture wars might seem to have shifted political discourse to policy differences and disputes about justice, fairness, freedom, truth, and human rights. As welcome as that change might be, the truth is that the dominant rhetoric seldom includes genuine dialogue and tends to dissolve into propaganda and name-calling. As Whitehead put it so well, we need to employ the primary function of reason, which is to promote the art of life. In this episode, I will take a closer look at this philosophical issue by exploring Plato's form of reason as an alternative to materialism. To understand and explain the gap between digital computers and human beings, I will take a closer look.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.